Welcome back. We all do it. We leave food out after a party or after dinner before cleanup and wonder how long is too long.
Yeah, it's a pretty complicated process and it involves microbiology, public health. So who would be the perfect expert to have to talk about it? How about Michelle Williams from Jacksonville University to help us out with this?
Thanks for having me.
Well, thanks for coming on the show. So that's what we need help with, is figuring out how long can foods actually stay out and still be good. And we're doing this right before lunchtime, so.
Good time. And, you know, we've got the Super Bowl coming up, yeah. So we're going to have big parties that are going to be up. We just finished all of our holidays, so unfortunately we missed those. But it's a really good thing for us to understand. And so the temperatures that bacteria like are going to be from 40. These are what we call the danger temperatures. And okay. It's between 40 and 140 degrees. So 40 degrees is what the refrigerator should be,
okay.
Ideally set to. 140 degrees is going to be just under what your meat should be cooked to. So the idea is that we want to keep hot foods hot and cold foods cold as long as possible. So if they're sitting out at a party, we want to keep them at those temperatures. So use a warming dish or set your deviled eggs on ice. But if it's going to have to be out without any kind of control measures, then we're going to want to take and have, especially at that temperature that the bacteria like, we want to keep it down to 2 hours.
And what's the temperature that bacteria likes?
So bacteria like temperatures between, say, the moderate temperatures in that range, which is maybe 60 to 110.
Uh-huh. Okay, yeah, that's a pretty big
room temperature would always be
75.
Okay.
The temperature that we are, approximately 98 degrees. You know, so the bacteria that are going to cause disease really like those temperatures. And we've provided them with food. And so they're going to rapidly divide at those temperatures.
And when you
talk
about
the food, you want to minimize that.
When you talk about the food, does it change? So, for example, chicken to steak to meat, does it matter or does it have the same effect?
It really doesn't matter because it's going to still give the same kind of environment to these bacteria. Now, some foods may have different bacteria that we may be worried about. Say, chicken have maybe salmonella. So there's different bacteria that are associated with those. But in terms of them rapidly dividing, it makes no difference.
Right.
It's a difference of who's coming to your house.
Right.
Either way, you're making the house nice and welcoming for them.
Exactly. You know, it's going to be the bacteria party.
And then here's a whole other issue is how long you store them. So say you do get them put up.
Right.
Then you can't keep them longer than
that. Once you get them in the refrigerator, for fresh salads and cut up fruits, we're going to want to minimize that to just a couple of days. And you really should eat those in those couple of days. Then as we go out, cooked meats, cooked vegetables, up to your casseroles, kind of increasing out, but really to three or four days. And then part of that is also going to be who you're feeding it to.
Perfect, yeah.
And then
like the thing that you said too, when in doubt, throw it out.
Yeah, when in doubt, throw it out. You know, if you think that it's not going to be good, just go ahead and throw it away.
Perfect.
Don't smell it and then say, mm-mm.
And most of these diseases that you might be getting from food, you can't smell it.
Okay.
You're not going to see a difference. You're not going to smell a difference. So you don't have anything to kind of guide yourself by except for time.
All right. Well, Michelle Williams, thank you so much for coming out. We appreciate
it.
When in doubt, throw it out. I think that's the key here. Temperature and timing. This is something actually good to go to our Facebook page and share so you don't pass around these bacteria and all that stuff for everybody
else.
All right. Well, we'll have more after this.